Hi, I'm Mike, co-founder and CEO of Hummingbot, and today I wanted to give you a brief introduction into market making. So Hummingbot is an open source project that helps you build and run crypto trading bots. It's open source under Apache 2, so it's totally free, and all the code is available on GitHub. We've tried to make it open to everyone, so you don't need to know how to code. You can just answer a bunch of questions and set up a trading bot. We launched Hummingbot about 1 year ago, and since then, we've grown into a pretty large community of algorithmic traders and developers. It's a community-led project, so we have a bunch of external contributors to the project, and our mission overall is to democratize algo trading. And since market making is one of the core algo trading strategies, I wanted to give a brief introduction about it today. So today I'll cover the history of market making, why you should be in market making, and some of the basics into how it actually works. So this is a picture of New York City in the early 1900s. And if you look at these people here standing in the street, they were the first market makers. And so one of these people, their job was to make a market in a single stock. So one of them might be GE or General Electric. And so the market maker would offer to buy GE at $10 and then also offer to sell it for $12. And that market maker would just maintain those buy and sell offers throughout the day, hope that takers, the traders, come in and hit those offers. And if they did, that market maker would buy low, buy $10, and sell higher at $12 all day long. As the market moved, let's say the price went up, then the market maker might start offering to buy at 11 and selling at 13. So constantly adjusting those offers as the day went on. And then one day, these market makers got together and said, "Why are we standing on the street? It's kind of cold. It's kind of hot out. It's kind of, you know, dirty out here. Let's go indoors." So they got a building, and they formed a club where they all had seats, and each market maker would market make for an individual stock. And this company became known as the New York Stock Exchange. Fast forward 50 years, and you can see, you know, now they had a great, nice modern building. The market makers are now wearing, spiffy blue jackets, but the core activity remained exactly the same. They were placing offers to the general public and buying low and selling high. And then after the 1990s, everything became electronified. So no longer are people doing this. Now you have machines that are placing orders on order books, adjusting them automatically as the market moves, and then profiting from that spread. But once again, the core thing they were doing, buying low and selling high, was exactly the same. So now I'm going to cover why you should be a market maker, because this world of market making, it doesn't seem like something that ordinary people can even compete on, right? And that is actually true in equities, because in equities, placing an order on the order book is really only available to a select few. And that's because, if you recall, the New York Stock Exchange was actually a club, an exclusive club of market makers. So when you place an order on Robinhood, you place an order with your phone, it gets passed to a market maker, and then only the market maker can then place that order on NYSE. As an individual, you have no way to access the NYSE order book, so you can't actually be a market maker in equities. However, in crypto, we have direct market access. Because there are thousands of exchanges, all of them make available their APIs, publicly available. And so whether you're Ray Dalio, founder and CEO of Bridgewater Associates, or your random crypto bro, we can all access the market directly, and we can all be market makers. And that opens up a whole new world of trading that was just never possible in equities before. And so that's why for algo trading, in crypto, you can do directional trading, which is trying to predict where the market goes and then just trading against it. But you can also do more kind of like more sophisticated strategies like market making, where you basically post offers and wait for people to hit you. And you can do arbitrage, which is finding mispriced trades in the market, mispriced orders, and then taking advantage of them to make a risk-free profit. Because arbitrage is harder to do nowadays, the markets are relatively efficient. We think market making is still an area in crypto where there's a lot of room available to play for both individuals and professionals. So the last part, let me give you a brief introduction into how market making works at a very basic level. So recall again the order book. And as a market maker, what you're really doing is simply creating and canceling orders on the order book. So let's say this is the order book, and I have four sell orders and four buy orders. The first thing to notice is that the buy orders are lower than sell orders, because you always want to buy at a lower price than where you sell, right? And the second thing is there's a spread. The spread is a difference between where your buy orders are and your sell orders. And because you always want to buy low and sell high, the spread is really how you make money. So let's say someone comes along and takes one of my orders. And so now I have basically sold this sold some, and I'm hoping that someone comes and then takes this lower, this other buy order here. Because if someone takes both a sell order and a buy order, now I've just bought low and sold high. But if someone doesn't, I might need to replace that order with a different one, or if the market price has moved, I might need to, you know, I actually might end up losing money on that trade. So market making is really about kind of like placing orders on the order book and then adjusting them as the market moves. So how do you make money? How do you know which markets you should operate in? A very simple rule of thumb is that your profit is equal to the spread times the volume. So because your spread is kind of the distance between your buy and sell orders is kind of how, it's kind of like how much money you make on one or two trades. And so your volume is how many takers are coming to the market and trading. And so you can roughly estimate your profit to be spread times volume. And in the next series of videos, I'll talk a lot more about this and how to pick a market and how to respond to different types of market scenarios. With this one, I wanted to just give you the basics today. Thanks. See you later. Bye.